Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We start our CME on off-label use of drugs in ophthalmology. We have no financial disclosures, and our faculty includes senior defense ophthalmologists from all over the countryside. To begin with, off-label use of medicines in ophthalmology, as you Google search on this topic, you see a large number of results, more than 6 lakh results you see on the Google search. What is off-label use of drugs? It means any drug or expendable which is used for an unapproved indication, in an unapproved age group, in an unapproved dose, and unapproved form of administration. Means off-label dosage, different indication, different route of administration, or different age group. Once you go to the literature of ophthalmic medications, one finds that more than 50% of ophthalmic medications which are being used are off-label. And this figure goes to more than 90% in cases of children. As far as the financial implication is concerned, about $44 million market is there of off-label drugs in US. Indian figures are not known. The question arises, why off-label drugs are used and is gaining popularity? The first cause is the increasing expectations of the patients. Every patient wants the quick recovery for all the illnesses. Many of the illnesses don't have a definite medicine, so off-label drugs are used in these cases. Second is cost effectiveness. We are using Avastin instead of Lucentis because of the low cost. Third, the clinical trials are less commonly done in cases of children, pregnant and lactating women, and elderly, as we can see in the corona vaccine. Next point is, after all the labeled drugs are used, still the patient is not happy, so off-label drugs are used to treat patients. Next point is, for rare diseases, very limited drugs are, and the studies have been conducted, so off-label drugs are being used in these cases also. Similarly, in cases where symptoms are similar to known disease, unauthorized use or off-label use of medicines are used. In addition to these, many a times you see that off-label drugs are used by various hospitals or doctors to prove that they are better than the others, based on the, they are listed high in the pharmacy. These drugs are discussed in every magazine, on the web, and used by millions of doctors and people to show that they are better than the others. However, not all these off-label drugs have their own limitations. First, if not used with scientific data, they have restricted, unrestricted experimentation on the patients. There is unknown health risk associated with these diseases and the procedures. And sometimes these medicines and the procedures are ineffective. In addition to these, there are serious adverse effects, as we saw a few years back, Avastin-related endophthalmitis. And one should also keep a check that the patient, if not treated properly or develops some complications, can go to court, and there can be problem for the prescribing doctor. As far as the Indian scenario is concerned, Drug Controller General of India is the final authority as far as the drugs approval is granted. For off-label use of drugs, there are no clear-cut guidelines about these. And currently, none of the off-label use drugs are approved by the Drug Control Journal of India. So, to avoid any litigations, we have to have continuous education. We should have scientific knowledge about the use of these drugs. We must inform the patient and the attendant clearly, and should have a meticulous record keeping of the case sheets and the consents and everything which are done for these drugs. As far as the drug companies are concerned, as far as the law is concerned, off-label drug selling is a violation of law in India and is an offense. However, most of the pharmaceutical companies, they go for selling off-label drugs because of the finances involved in the getting approval from the drug controller, and as this process is lengthy and costly. It is impractical to expect the pharmaceutical companies to restrict or stop off-label promotion.